Well, that was fun. I'm back. Sorry about that. The game froze. Whoopsie doodle. Yeah, bummer. Oh well. All better now. There we go. Link in the old chat. And thanks for joining me again, guys. Boom. Sorry about that. It happens with this game, I guess. Just gotta keep moving on. At least I just hit this save point, right? At least it didn't lose much. At least I can start off. Oh, look at him. Quite lovely. Red dot. Where was it? Did I just go past it? There it is. You're a predator. You're trying to get me. Whoa! You're a fast one. Defensive. Gagiabus Razaver. Gagiabus. So, I don't think it saved the two that I got over here, but they're not over here any- Oh! I spoke too soon. Ruzizarium. Okamiank. Okamiank. My, my. My, my. Well, hey, let's get some waypoints named for some chatters. Who made it into this one first? That was SavJazz21. Thanks for joining. Did I get that right? Did I scroll all the way up? Yeah, I sure did. This will be... Oh. The SavJazz21 Woods. Boom. I like to name the waypoints after the people who join me in chat, so feel free to say, hey, I'll try to keep up with them as best I can. That's the first waypoint I've hit since I started playing tonight, so we'll see how I do. See how we do. Johnny Cage Pro, welcome to the chat. Glad you like it. We like it too. We sure do. We do, do, do. I've got some extra emerald and aluminum I could get rid of. Oh, not all of it. Brandon Pierce Boyd, where's my muffins? Where's my muffins? Incoming storm. Get him. Yes, I also hope that I find Sean Murray on one of the planets inside of his game. Sosa Renew Razaver. There's the other gender, symmetric. I can hear him. Oh, that was the big predator that I found? That's a bummer. This thing? No. Yeah, this guy. That's the top predator. 1.38 meters tall. It's nothing. I need a big creature. Huge. Look at that little guy. Gagiabis razaver. Oh, it's an infant. Ew. Look at its head. Ew. Ew. Zooksku-klite. Thanks for subscribing. Sorry. Sorry about trying to pronounce your name just now. Oh, that guy with his 5 accounts came by. Good, good, good. I'd hate to miss out on that. How bored do you have to be? How bored do you have to be? Click the button. Click to sign out. Click to sign in. Click confirm on password. Click back to the video. Click the button again. Repeat. 5 times. Like, cool, man. I'm glad you like these videos that much. I'm so glad. Thank you for being a troll. Look at this crater lake. Wow. Wowie, wow, wow, wow. I like the crater lakes. I've been seeing a lot of these, it seems like. Here near the center. Oh, get up there. Oh, oh hey. We're just hanging out. Pretty. Oh, man. Zeusquiclite. 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 Yeah, this would be a good spot for a time lapse, Brandon. I was thinking the same thing. Hell, I don't know. Maybe I'll turn this into a scenery broadcast after I finish the animal list, you know? Because this is a nice LP, as our good friend GM Gameplay would say. Lush planets. Lush planets. What do we want? Lush planets. When do we want them? All the time. All the time. Splash. Oh, I didn't get it. I didn't get the speed boost. Zeusquiusalite. 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 These caves. Oh no, I didn't mean to jump in. Jazzman Worlds Federation. Oh, I wonder if I should have numbered it or something. Flash floods would be awesome. Brandon needs more of the time lapse. Okay, okay. I'll get some time lapse tonight. It's all good. I just gotta finish this animal list first, that's all. I know I saw some over this way. There's a dot. Green dots. I don't want no stinking green dots. Well, I tried, Zeusk. He didn't call me Hey Zeus, he said Hey Zeus. As in Zeus, father of Apollo. Don't fuck with me or I'll shove a lightning bolt up your ass. Anybody see Die Hard with a Vengeance? Anybody? Samuel L. Jackson? It was great. It was great. He didn't call me Hey Zeus, he said Hey Zeus. Nice wings, you little warthog. Uh-oh. Oh my goodness. You guys make me laugh. Especially you, John Otter. You just wait. You just wait until you have a good line and then you throw it out there and then you disappear for like half an hour. Perfect. Where are they? The storms are frequent on this moon. Suit Riot. All the crater lakes on this planet. All of them. Did you really, Sav Jazz? Finally. Finally. Perpetually balmy. Dots keep going. Green dot. Green dot. Might seem a little severe. Zeus suit riot. Oh, where did I... Oh, that tree was faking me out. There's no land under that tree. Planet has some strange topography. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh, I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna get him. Oh, I'm gonna get him. Hey, welcome to the new viewers, by the way. Thanks for joining us here on the journey tonight in No Man's Sky. I'm Gaming Mike. I found this lush moon near the center of the Euclid Galaxy, so I am seeking out strange new life, but not new civilizations. I'm really kind of ambling along as opposed to going boldly. But it was an undiscovered system, so I can safely say that no man has gone here before. And that's where we're at. Thanks for joining. Click like if you like it, subscribe for more in the future, etc. etc. Where are the animals? Where are the dots? Planets usually have canyons, or is it just a coincidence? I have seen crater lakes like this. Canyons, I don't know, if you're calling what we're seeing on this planet canyons, it does seem like there have been some canyony areas. But this, no, it's, I haven't seen a planet that has them quite like that. They do seem pretty pronounced here. The canyon-like drop-offs and such. And the rivers. I've seen a few rivers around here. Lots of water, lots of crater lakes, all that stuff. All that stuff. Zidizayo. Zidub Zabzuze. Bredabadido. Duerete. Zidub Zayaya. The cherry poppin' daddies. Wow. Way to go, Zeusk. You got Zoot Suit Riot in my head. Just by having your name. Ethuic, if there was a 100% ocean planet, you would not be able to land your ship. So what would be the point? I think that might be part of the reason. I think that might be part of the reason. Zezuzo zezu. Buerete. Get out of here. You're not a red dot. You're a green dot. Nobody cares about green dots. If I wanted to see a green dot animal, I'd pull open my animal Rolodex and look it up. Yeah, they could do a water planet that still had the structures with the landing pads, as long as they were generated far enough above the water for you to be able to land. That is true. It'd be a little water world type situation where you just have the floating atolls, Kevin Costner mutants locked up in cages above the sludge where you recycle the bodies. Dinky little lime trees. That you need to survive so you don't get scurvy. while you're out there recycling your own urine on the open ocean, hunting for strange collectibles in the ruins of a previous civilization that lies below the waves? Yeah, I'd go to a water world. In the chat and wondering how many people knew that I was describing the movie Waterworld just now. I know Damn It Man did. But hey, if you think that sounds good, go watch Waterworld starring Kevin Costner and Dennis Hopper. Special appearance by Jack Black. Spot Jack Black in Waterworld and win the prize of laughter. I think that's the second time I've talked about Waterworld in the last couple weeks while playing No Man's Sky on stream. I guess that makes sense. I guess the subject of watery worlds does come up with this game. Smeet for everyone! Smeet. All the money they spent on that movie, they couldn't buy the rights to say spam. Spam was too much for them. Spam was outside the budget of Waterworld. So instead they had Smeet. Red Dot. Suck. You were supposed to be red. Oh no. Good thing I wasn't too far off the ground. Time lapse alert. Yeah, the other planets are all pretty consistent with themselves. I mean, you'll see similar topography throughout. Is there something particular that's standing out about this planet to you? Like the way it's shaped? What are you thinking? I'm talking to Law712 in the chat. When did YouTube gaming come to exist? I think just a little over a year ago. Green Dot Hater, yeah. When I'm looking for red dots, I'm a green dot hater. Spam. Oh. You know, you haven't been able to bring up spam without evoking Monty Python since the 60s. It's like 50 years. It's like 50 years that Monty Python and spam have just been basically joined at the hip. Metaphorically joined at the hip. Is that chrysonite? Wow. Somebody, I don't remember where I saw it, but I saw something that said chrysonite is only found on cold planets. So I guess that's not true. Something I read somewhere that I just went along with. But not anymore. dotism is making you sad, Masakiro? Making you sad? Well, I still don't like the green dots. Still don't like the green dots. They distract me from what's better. Oof. These trees are really good at hiding the cliffs. Ugh. This planet's got its own kind of dangers. This moon has its own kind of dangers. Aha! Aha! Scan it. I'm creeping on you. What are you? Arhu's Ukulmiank. That's the other predator. Was he a predator? I didn't see his temperament. Docile. Nope. Not a predator. Two more animals to go. One of them is up here. Aren't you? Where are you? Ah, it's a green dot. Ah! Come here, I'm gonna feed you. Ah, I fed you. You like me now. Ha ha ha. Too bad it doesn't work like that with trolls. There you go, troll. Have some attention. Oh, okay. I'll stop being a jerk. Wouldn't that be nice? Oxonium cuscoria. Get up off of that thing. There. Out of my way, Sentinel. You know what they could do with this game is just go full Pokemon Safari style with it and start introducing like legendary level creatures, and some planets would have the really super rare, massive, freaky stuff. Like there would be a lot of common animals on a lot of planets, like the stuff we're used to seeing, but they just start introducing rarer and rarer creatures, and they only appear in certain conditions. Like one creature, you have to be on a toxic planet with temperatures over a certain temperature and, you know, certain mixture of chemicals in the friggin' atmosphere. I don't know, make it as specific as you like, but you have to find planets with those certain conditions to see those certain animals, and then you get lots of points for collecting them all. That's just one layer they could add on to this game without losing anything. And it would just flesh it out so much more. Look out! Did I just fall into a crater lake? Well, this is awkward, okay. I didn't see the hole there, sorry. My bad. Thank you. shiny crab spiders. 55 meter long. Yeah, I've seen some pretty wacky creatures. I've watched a little bit of Stat playing Subnautica, and yeah, there's some weird looking stuff in that game. Mast Hero, I'm with you on the genetically modifying creatures and affecting their evolution, not necessarily for the same reasons as you, but that would be fun also, to be able to do that. You can make your creatures look however you want. And I'll do the same. You think I can make it across the crater? I'm not gonna make it. Oh, I made it. Oh, I made it. Oh. Get up off of that thing. Keep getting these songs stuck in my head tonight. And these shall be the planes of whoever talked after the last Nightbot message. Athuic! The planes of Athuic! Boom. For those just joining us, I do like to name the waypoints in this game after the people who are chatting with us in the chat. So feel free to join in the conversation. Say hey. Get yourself immortalized. Masked Hero, you have goals. I can say that much for you. You have goals. Is this live, man? Vishnu, yes, we are broadcasting live right now. That's right. Welcome to the chat. Thank you for joining. There is about a 10-second delay, so be aware of that. If you chat, it'll take about 10 seconds from when I see it for you to hear the response. Oh, did I misspell that? No. What are you talking about? Is that Heridium? Just sticking right out of the lake, huh? Interesting. Oh, yes. Red dots. It's the predator. Belongs to species already discovered. Predator. You see that one pop in right there? Come on, game. Come on, game. The song of the headbutter. Green dots. Son of a bee. Huge crater lakes. Yeah, this planet, this moon has a lot of them. And I think they're lovely. Lovely. So lovely it makes me sick. Not really. Where are you, dots? This is a very nice moon, though. For sure. Oh, if those end up being fish, I'm going to be slightly disappointed. Time-lapse alert. You guys keep saying time-lapse. It's just tempting me further and further to turn this into a scenery stream. I mean, I'll do it. I'll do it. I've done it before. A troll planet. Boom. Nightbot just said something. Oh, this one's for Zeusk. This one's for Zeusk. New to the chat tonight. Thanks for joining us, man. This is your forest. Now let's see as I make sure I type this right. E-U-C. L-I-T-E? Yeah. The forest. Sav Jazz, welcome back. Brandon Pierce Boyd, we'll see you next time. Cannot accept it. Oh my goodness. Zeus, does your name mean something dirty? There you go. It's the Zeusk Forest. Yeah, it doesn't like your name. It doesn't like it at all. That's pretty funny. That is pretty funny. You haven't had love since, John Otter? That's tragic. Gaming Mike accepts no responsibility for the love lives of the patrons of the stream. You're on your own, pal. Green dots everywhere. Oh, you know what? Oh, hold on. I'll ask that question after I answer it. Not the plant, you fool. You coming to attack me? No. You're docile. See, John Otter, it all balances out. So these two could be cave animals. Do the cave animals come before or after flying types in the list? Does anybody know? I can never remember the order. I have seen caves on this planet. I suppose I can just go run into one to check. Next time I see one. Aluminum. Ow. Mostly benevolent dictator, huh? Wow. Boom, first one after night bot. Stab Jazz already had one. So this one's for Masked Hero. This is your jungle. Welcome to the jungle, Masked Hero. We got fun and games. There we go. Two more animals. Oh yeah, I need to look in some caves. I need to find some caves. Oh my. Oh my. Oh, look at him. Screw that. It's time lapse. I'm going to get a time lapse right here, guys. We're going to be looking at this view for a minute. Strap in. Enjoy it. I want to start it while the storm's still going. Time lapse. Why don't I quote Elton John songs ever? Have I not? Well, I hope you don't mind, John Otter. I hope you don't mind. Oh, and then Law 17. I was reading down from the top of the chat. Me and Law 17 are on the 712. Sorry, Law 712 are on the same page. Good call, Sav Jazz. Good call. Having a little scenery break. In fact, I'm going to go grab a drink of water, and I will be back shortly. Clearing. I'm back. My, my. Isn't she lovely? Oh, you know what? I'll try something with this time lapse. Here's my ship. A nice panorama time lapse, eh? There's the sun. There's the lens flare. I'm J.J. Abrams, Ma. I'm J.J. Plato-ramas and cup-o-ramas go over much better, eh, John? That's John Otter with the puns. He's a punny guy. This hurts my thumb. Killian Bolton, welcome to the chat. Yes, I've been at the center for a while now. All week, at least. Oh, my thumb hurts. Gonna give myself carpal tunnel doing panorama time lapses on No Man's Sky. Full loop around. Yeah. All right, I'm no longer worried about my thumb. I'm gonna grab this sunset for the time lapse and then I'll be moving on. But hey, thanks for joining in the stream, those who are watching. Be sure to drop a like if you're enjoying. Subscribe for more in the future. You can check out my channel for more of these. There's some links coming out from Nightbot, or they were. Scroll up a bit in the chat. I've got a playlist of time lapse scenery from this game posted on my channel. You can check those out. See what the finished product of something like this will look like. Ooh, another storm. The storms are frequent on this moon. They're very frequent. Aaron Macklin, welcome back. Temperature levels stabilizing. Yeah, No Man's Time Lapse, that's right. Because this game is pretty. Right by me, there goes the ship. It's way balmy on this planet. It's a balmy storm on a balmy moon. Savjazz, I didn't see. Did you post a picture of your balmy planet on Twitter? I'm going to look right now. Yeah. Balmy. That's so great. Oh, that's so great. Balmy. Somebody was gonna find one sooner or later. We said it long enough, right? It's like we should have had a pool going for who could find one first or something. There's a link in the chat in the for Savjazz's tweet to his balmy planet that he found. What the? Oh. Nice to see you guys keeping it topical there in the chat. The guy wanted to see how far he could go on the planet. Stopped him at about 100 kilometers. You cannot even go everywhere in the game. Wow, that's kind of a bummer. You can only go 100 kilometers out in that game? Huh. Interesting. I've seen a few streams of Osiris. I mean, it looks alright. A 100 kilometers seems really small when you've got something like this, though. No Man's Sky. Balmy. ...260 kilometer squared zone that you can go on that game. I mean, that's pretty big. It's a lot of area. Osiris is too balmy for you. And there goes that sunset. Pretty. Alright. That ought to make a nice time lapse, eh? Now where am I? Oh, the sun didn't set all the way. Oh, the sun's not going to set all the way. I'm right at the edge. Is it really rising again? Or is it going... Yeah, it's rising again. Or is it setting very slow? I can't tell if the sun's going up or down. What is going on with this thing? It's going straight across. No, it's going up. No. What is the sun doing? Here goes that ship. It's just going across. The stars are out though. It's full on nighttime. This might just be the right spot on the planet. It's just going straight across. There. Yeah. Found the sweet spot. Nice. This is hilarious. This is the sweet spot on the planet. It's as far as I can tell in this game, the solar systems are stationary and the sun rotates around the solar system. So it makes sense that if you're on the right spot of a planet, lined up the right way to the sun, that it would do this. I haven't seen it before. I didn't mean to land in the sweet spot. That's funny. That's so funny. Yeah, sorry guys, I was going to move to a new spot before I realized the sun's doing this, but now I'm going to get a time lapse of this thing going around. In fact, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and update the title of the video too. There we go. I wonder if the sun, I just didn't notice it last time, or during the daytime, I guess. It must have just been crawling right across the horizon still. That's so funny. Yes, Zeus, if you're not having fun, you will be banned from the stream. Banned forever. It's in the rules. I didn't make the rules. Actually, I did. But it's in the rules. Those hammers aren't messing around. Bye-bye. The outpost, yeah, it's been there. I saw it before I turned the camera last time. See, it looks like it's coming up a little bit now. JJ. There we go. Rotate in. Yeah, damn it, man. I've been broadcasting on PlayStation. The highest you can go is 720 60 FPS. But if you set it that way, you cannot record while you play. But if you set it to just 720 without the 60 FPS, you can still record. So that's what I've been doing when I play No Man's Sky, just in case I want to take a video, is I set it to 720 without the 60 FPS, just in case. And I'm glad I did today. Because this one's going to be good. This is going to be a good time lapse. With the camera changes, yeah. I'm going to really like this one. I can tell already. Yeah, SavJazz, it warns you when you switch to 60 FPS. It says gameplay recording no longer available or something. It warns you. Oh man, SavJazz, I just realized this entire time lapse, all the time lapses I get on this planet are just going to be advertising your Federation too. Yeah, Zeus, other time lapses on the channel. Read this message from Nightbot. There's a link. You can click it. SavJazz got it too. You get the idea. But yeah, if you click that link, that's a playlist to the other time lapses I've done. Look at that. Eye of Sauron. The Eye of JJ Flyby. Oh, perf. I got that shot. So yeah, that message from Nightbot in the chat has a link to the time-lapse playlist. Here comes the sunrise, right as the sun crosses. This is going to be such a good one. Oh my god. This one's going to be so good. I need to find out what it's called. What is this place on a planet called where you see... What would it be called? We don't have that on our planet. Boom. Glorious sunrise. It's only going day to night because it knows it has to. I think the sun did come up a little bit for daytime and a little down for nighttime. It's the apex? Is it the apex? Does that apply to a planet? To a sphere? I'm rusty on that kind of terminology. Oh, okay, just a guess. Sounds good. It sure sounds good. Arctic J, you run max settings and record? Interesting. I mean, I'm only going by the warning it gives me when I switch. Three ships on the flyby. When those ships are out of sight, I will adjust. There they go. Off into space. Sunrise and a storm over a crater lake at the apex or whatever. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, Arctic, if you're on PC, that's a different story. For sure. For sure.
Weather update. Storm clearing.
Storm's clearing. Good day.
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Yeah, PC Master Race likes to forget the PS4, but that's okay. It's just my Netflix machine that also plays games. That's all. Brandon Sudath, welcome to the chat. John Otter thinks this game would work so much better as an implanted microchip. And you know what? I agree. I agree with that sentiment. Yeah, it's got a video editor too. I haven't really used it, but I know it's there. Oh, nice. Sav Jazz. I just saw your comment about editing a video and putting it up on Twitter. You should post a link to that tweet and let me see it, actually. How long has the live stream been so far? Look underneath the title of the video on YouTube. It will tell you. It will tell you everything. Everything you want to know. Boom. Yeah, there we go. Oh, nice. Transitions and everything, huh? Interesting. Maybe I'll have to play with that some more. Oh, and you can do voiceover too? Nice. Well, I'll be.
Incoming storm.
Boom. Keep enjoying the views, guys. I will be right back. Zeus, the, let's see, a day in the game lasts half an hour on a moon. On planets, I think it's closer to 47 minutes for a full game day. I think. I'm not sure if that's accurate. Hold on. I've done time lapses on both. No, one of the planets, it did have a 30-day cycle. It did. And that would make sense, especially if the sun's going around the systems. Especially if the sun's going around the systems. Yeah, yeah, settle down, suit. Welcome to the new viewers. Gaming Mike here, playing some No Man's Sky tonight. Right now I'm taking a time-lapse video of this scene, so the gameplay is minimal, but thanks for joining us. You can find links in the chat if you scroll up a little bit from Nightbot to time-lapse, and a little bit of explanation on what it is I'm doing. It's also in the description. Be sure to check that out, so you know what's up. In the meantime, feel free to join in the chat while you're here. And thanks for watching. I'm almost done with this game day, and then I'll be moving on. I've still got a couple animals to find on this planet, so I'll be looking for those. But if I come across another interesting spot, I may stop again. Just so you know. Oh, those are a couple of hoop ships. A lot of storms on this moon. Sun should be setting soon, and I started this one not long after sunset, so almost done with this shot. Yeah, it looks like we're at about the 27-minute mark. Should be about 3 more minutes. Yeah, there it goes. There it goes. Boom, 3 ship flyover, right as the sun sets. Just as it was getting to its ring. Look at that. Oh, that's gonna be a pretty shot. Oh my, that's tasty. That's tasty. Delicious. Goodbye, sun. Even though you're not going anywhere. Oh, man. Wow. That's great. That's fantastic. Zoom zap zoozy. Bread up and eat up. A bue de bue. Boom za ya ya ya. Zoom zap zoozy. Yeah, stars popping out. This shot started at the beginning of sunset and ends in full nighttime, even though the sun didn't move. That's perfect. Oh, this is the sweet spot. The sweetest. Arnold. Oh, masked hero. Oh, that was a pretty one. Oh, I can't wait to see that one all finished up. Oh, I can't wait to see what free songs on YouTube fit well with it. Oh, look at the blue streak as I let it pass off camera. Goodbye. Wow. Wow. Goodness, this was a good spot to stop. Spot to stop, good spot to stop. Almost gone. The sun is almost gone from this shot. It's got to get all the way up. It's got to. There it goes. Fly, fly, fly. Fly, fly, fly. Goodness, that's going to be a good time lapse. Still a little bit of orange. Still a little bit. All right. Call that good. Hey, son. So, two more animals. I need to check some caves. I've re-updated the title and description of the video. That concludes the scenery broadcast portion for now. I'll resume gameplay. There's my ship. I think I was on my way to the ship to find a new spot and hopefully... Yeah, I was gonna fly around and look for caves. Wahoo! Here's a cave. The trouble is, I think a lot of the caves I've seen so far have been all underwater. And, well, makes it a little bit difficult to find any cave animals. One. Oh, good. That was easy. Stormy, so stormy. Oh my. Oh, let's see. They should be, yeah, they should be land creatures. I'm wondering now if cave comes before or after the flyers. Because I still don't remember the exact order of that list. Whose grassland is this? Whose grassland? Brandon Sudath. Grassland, he joined us in the chat. So there you go. Thanks for joining. Land, air, cave, water. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. So they should be land animals. Oh, Masked Hero, I appreciate it. I'm glad you enjoy. Maybe I should get an ASMR microphone. Start doing that. What's the deal? I mean, no, I don't want to start doing that. I barely even know what that is. I've heard of it. I don't quite understand what its purpose is. Unless the purpose is to sound a certain way. I did watch one guy maybe a week or so ago, and he was broadcasting ASMR, and he even started talking about how he changes the way he talks for his broadcasts, and that people might be surprised to hear his actual voice, because it's quite a bit different than how he talks while he's broadcasting. That lake is full of them. Little guys. Little anglers. You listened to someone cutting hair. Huh. Oh yeah, that was from that raid. That was from that raid, you're right, Savjazz. Green dot in the tall grass. What if they're little insects? Doesn't really matter because their dots still show up the same. Oh my. Fast Hero. Oh my, oh my. Yeah, what does ASMR stand for? Something, sound, microphone, recording. Simultaneous. Awesome sound, microphone, recording. Awesome sound, microphone, recording. I figured it out. I know what ASMR stands for now. Green dots. The majestic beasts. Get out of here. It doesn't stand for Google. Nuh-uh. Nuh-uh. Shit, I don't have enough jetpack for this. Go to the lake! I made it! Perfect. Jetpack recharge. Wow, look at that planet looming overhead. Wowie zowie. Holy cow, I think it's just right there. Huge. Autonomous sensory meridian response. Wow, I was way off. Meridian response. Ah, the meridians. That's gonna be a red dot across the lake, across Crater Lake. Banzai! Come on, red dot. It's a green dot. Damn it. It was all for nothing. Oh, look at that cave. Landscape. Sorry about that.
Weather warning. Incoming storm.
What is that? What the hell? What kind of glitched out?
Temperature levels stabilizing.
What is that? What was that? Some weird texture in the sky. I don't know if you guys saw it between those trees. Huh. Weird. Oh, hey, butterfly. Were those the large ones? 2.27 meters. Yeah, those are pretty big for flyers. Pretty big for a flyer. Oh. Out of jetpack again. Yeah, some glitch. Yeah, that was weird, huh? Why are there two markers? Oh, that's just some other waypoint. It's just something else. I see. Fields of Chrysonites. My ship. Oh my gosh. I really went wandering, didn't I? Mr. Big M, welcome to the stream. You know what? That guy. Green dots, oh. Green dots, green dots. Trixie fishes. Trixie fishes. Boom. Green dots. Green dots. Green dots. else. Oh, there they are. Oh, out of jetpack. Green dot. Oh, wasting my time. I just want to find the last two. Ow. The last two animals. Ow. My ship, finally. The Sav Jazz 21 Woods on the Jazzman World's Federation planet. That's right. I made it through the wilderness. Somehow I made it through. And there's a trade hole right here for all this chrysonite I picked up. Right, even though the prices are crap. That works out. You get down with that panini, Athuic. Athuic? Athuic. Athuic. Sounds like Stewie Griffin sneezing sometimes if you say it right. No offense. Sorry, I'm not making fun of your name. I'm just thinking about it. Out loud. Athuic. Athuic. You know what? You know what? Those last two animals, they're not going to be big and freaky, and I'm really not going to find a better shot on this moon than what I've already gotten. And I'm just going to head to the planet. Let's go look at this planet. Let's go look at this planet. Let's go look at this planet. And wonder what it's like. Hey, guess the weather, Sentinels, Flora, and Fauna. If you get any one of those words correct, I'll name the planet after you. Average is not an acceptable guess on this round because it won last round. If we do two averages in a row, it's just not going to be cool. So there you go. Guessing before I land. It's got to be before I land. Once I land, the answer will be revealed. So, place your bets. Enter your guesses. It's watery. Weather, Sentinels, Flora, Fauna, guess, because I'm going to land after I find what if me and Sav Jazz both found a balmy planet on the same night after all this time of joking about balmy. Like Sav Jazz revived balmy as a guess by finding one. I'm gonna stop at this outpost. Yeah? Right up here on the mountaintop. Here it goes. Last chance. Last chance. Moment of truth. Frost, passive, average, numerous. This did not look like a cold planet. frost, passive, average, numerous. Nope. So sorry. Good guesses, though. Good guesses. Good guesses. So, what's the planet? Adrinskopet. Adrinskopet. Frost. Passive. Average. Numerous. And there you have it. Nope. Dot. Avi. Would have been amazing. What is this? Experiment 35Z? What a dumb experiment. What a dumb experiment. But what do you expect there, Viking? Oh! Yeah, hi. What are you doing back here? What's this? Just growing stuff? Drago, welcome to the chat. Nice to have you here. Just in time, I needed somebody to name a waypoint after anyway. This will be Drago Station. There you go. Welcome. Nice to have you. It's scarce here? How do you mean? This planet? Oh, it's got beasties on it. Show me them giant creatures. Show me something huge. Come on, game. Come on, game. There's something. Something tiny. It's a little bouncer. Vavand Snonelu. Vavend Snonelu. Oh, yeah. We got slimy bouncers all over this place. Oh, it's one of the pineapples. Favialho Vemcina. Vemcina. Red dot. See? Go to a new planet. Get red dots. It may not sound like something you want to do, but trust me, it is. Wow. Aviallo, Realmus Snonelu. Goodness. Owen West, welcome to the chat. What kind of ship do I have? It's called the Watahagib. It looks a little bit... What is this? That's not what I just scanned. It left off the body in that picture. It left off the body. There's the other gender. Age fluctuating. Green dot, green dot, green dot. Red dot. You there. What are ya? The other Snonelu. Wow, three Snonelus. Why are they all Snonelu? I don't understand. Oh yeah, here's a look at my starship, since you were curious. It looks like the EMP ships from the Matrix. It's got those bubbles on the side. So there you go. I'm not gonna kill the little bouncing blobbers. They're fine. But they are, yeah, they're the top of the list. So this is all going to be bouncy, blobby things. I'm not going to find big, freaky animals here. Unless I find a big, freaky blobber. Big, freaky thing. Ew, look at that one. Ruranos Jakusati. Ruranos Jakusati. Green dots. I need more red dots. Another one of those. Snow Nelu. This guy. Vavand. Snow Nelu. Green dots. Green dots. Whoa. Ugh. Out of jetpack. Oh, yeah. Oh, and I'm on PS4. For sure. I do not have a Steam account. Fish. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, that's a big one. With a big freaky tail. Oh, well, thanks, Owen. Indeterminate predator, insect eater. Smusa geumius epiriona. That's, oh, you didn't know that's what that fish was called? You didn't know that was its name? Give it the program. Smusa smunia, what is it? Smusa geumius. Smusajumus. Smusajumus. Aha! I knew I should go by this cave. I knew it. What are you, a predator? You're submissive. Go away. Get out of here. Acting tough. Acting so tough. Oh, yeah, so you know what? Where did this guy? Okay. Yeah. Cave is before fish, for sure. 39 mods on the game. Yeah, the mods look fun. I've seen some streams with the mods on the PC, and there's some really useful ones. I want that low fly mod. I want that most of all. What? Who's predatorizing me? This? No. Oh, it's the fish. Wow, look at him. What are you so intimidating for? You friggin' fish. Bye. Oh, here's your prey. Follow me over here. Got you, fishy. Got you. Wow, there's a lot. Oh, one moment. It looks like Rob's awake. What's he doing up at this hour? Okay. Rob, are you there? Well, I joined his party. One more type of fish. Two more on land. Why did that party not work? Where's Rob? Get up there. One sec, I need to check that. One moment. Oh, yeah, no, it says he's in the party, but he doesn't have a microphone going. Rob, if you can hear me, PlayStation says you've got no microphone. There he is.
Hello.
Now I can hear you.
Sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. It's that was that keypad that I bought for the PlayStation because it plugs into the microphone,
All right.
the headphone jacket on the PlayStation, and yeah, so.
Nice. Well, welcome. Everybody say hi to Rob of Exploring No Man's Sky. Let's see. I'll put a link from the Nightbot. I'll just put a
I'm
link to
not
your
streaming
channel.
it.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can put a link, but I'm not streaming at the moment. I've just woken up, and
Yeah, I figured
I
you must
saw
be just
you.
getting up.
I wasn't getting up, but I sort of like opened my eyes and I thought, I wonder if Mike's on because I want to see if he wants to go to that portal. But
I do.
yeah,
I'm
there you
headed
were.
back
So
there. There was a commotion today. Did you see any of what happened today in the Euclid Galaxy? Have you heard the news?
what about someone discovering the center?
Yeah.
That happened 2 days ago.
I know. I just heard about it earlier, a couple hours ago. So you already heard.
But yeah, I heard the, That happened on the 5th, I think it was, the 5th of
Yeah.
October. But I don't know what it means, because what does it mean?
Yeah, exactly. What did that guy do? Who is Sticks?
Yeah, I mean, I looked him up on Facebook, and he's got zero friends.
Really?
Yeah, he's got no friends on Facebook. Not on Facebook, sorry, on PlayStation.
Oh, okay.
So I did a search for him, and he's got no friends. So I don't know what he did, but anyway.
Well,
So I was
Quinton
just
Tribe,
waiting.
welcome to the chat. Sorry. Go ahead.
I thought maybe he was just the last person to jump through. That was my theory, but apparently it never used to say discovered by before.
Yeah, it's always been blank. So I don't know, everybody seems to think that that guy did something significant enough to actually get to the center and not be hurled away.
I don't know. I guess we'll find out. But I don't know. You'd think there would be some news or something, or maybe he's just not big on the.
Well, I figured he must not be a streamer if he didn't post a YouTube video about how to do it. I have this picture in my head of Styx being like this 12-year-old kid that just got the game and doesn't really read the news about it and doesn't know anything about any of the commotion surrounding the game, and he was just playing it. And he never thought to tell anybody he did it because he didn't even know it was a big deal. He didn't know people had been spending months looking for a way to do what he did. I like to think that's the case.
Maybe I'll just do a search for him again while I've got you here.
Yeah, see if you can dig anything up. That'd be interesting to find out if there's news.
I
But I
did a search
mean,
on Google for him and I couldn't find anything.
yeah.
But there is, I mean, there's a couple of sticks that, let's have a look.
But yeah, I found out about that today, so I left the meeting place system in that area, and I went looking around, seeing if I could find any of his previous discoveries around the center to try to get an idea of where he might have jumped. But I didn't find anything. So I'm taking the long way back to the meeting place system. I'm just exploring some planets. I got a really nice time lapse a little while ago from I was on the midpoint of the planet where the sun never sets, but it still hit daytime and nighttime, and the sun was like halfway over the horizon the entire time. It was really good. It's a really good shot, Rob. That's my story. It's after midnight here. I'm getting to that sleepy point of delirious just as you're waking up. It's kind of funny.
You've only just come on though, haven't you?
No, I've been going for 2 hours. Well, no, and then I had a half hour stream before that that crapped out, so about 2.5 at least.
I looked at my phone and it said you just started streaming at 7 o'clock.
Huh. Weird.
So, I don't know. But I'm gonna send this guy a friend request.
Yeah. I'm sure he's been getting that all day long for 2 days now.
He probably has.
I was watching Serious
Probably.
Gamer X. That's where I found out about it first, was from Serious Gamer X's stream. And he sent him a message on PlayStation while he was streaming, but no
Yeah.
response.
I don't know. Maybe he's somebody related to the game. I don't know.
That's another idea that seems to be floating around, is that maybe it's a Hello Games employee that logged in and did it, which has a certain amount of plausibility to it as well. I mean, that's one way to get people interested in the game again. Yeah, it wouldn't
I'm
really
just gonna.
surprise me to find out they had a plant and just, told one guy to go home and get on his personal account on his PlayStation and do the thing.
Yeah. But What I'm just gonna do is send him a message. Hey, you discovered the center in NMS. As someone who has
lusted after doing the same thing.
Yeah, basically someone who has played over 300 hours. I don't know how you did it. Played over.
What if he writes back and he's like, oh my god, I can't believe this game. It's so awful. I want my refund.
Yeah.
That's a big mushroom animal. 4.51 meters. That's pretty big for a hoppy blob.
I'll never hear back, will I?
It's probably, probably like, not.
Thousands of...
Oh, Masked Hero says hello to you, Rob. And so does Brandon Sudath.
Morning, guys. How you doing? Or afternoon, or evening, or wherever it is you may be in the world.
Yeah. All over the place. I watched a guy in Malaysia streaming Resident Evil today. I picked his stream because it was the only English-titled, English-speaking stream. So,
yeah,
that was kind of fun.
I was going to get back on last night, but I didn't.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to invite this guy to party chat at some point.
Yeah, do it.
Let's see. Maybe now.
Maybe you can get an exclusive interview before he gets bombarded with too many requests.
Yeah.
Or maybe you can be the last one on his pile when he checks it.
Yeah.
Oh, I can only imagine what his inbox is like right now. Probably not the best for them to put the username. I don't know. Some people don't want their username out like that, I think. I guess what does it matter if you're playing the game?
It doesn't matter. I mean, it's. I mean, you can. You don't have to answer anybody's requests, do you?
Yeah. You can also set it so only your current friends can send you messages, too.
Yeah. Which is probably what he's done, actually.
Yeah. Onion Plains. Onion! Let's see, who else joined the chat that we haven't named one after? Oh, that's right. We haven't named one after Owen West. How about the Owen West Plains? Okay. Oh. That new keyboard is real crisp.
It is if I was using it right now.
Oh, what are you typing on?
I had to unplug it.
Is that your controller?
My controller.
Oh.
Hey, can you hear that?
Yeah, I can hear the clicking.
Oh, well, me on the controller, not the beep 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 beep. Sorry. Okay.
Oh no, not those.
Okay. Right, so, hey, you discovered the sensor in NMS. As someone who has played over 300 hours, I'd love to know how you did it. I would like to party chat on air and YouTube about it if you are willing. Thanks.
Nice. Yeah, it's worth a shot. It's worth a shot to just see if he'll even, I don't know, grant you the interview, I guess.
Yeah, don't get on with some squeaky, squeaky voice kid.
Hey. I don't know what I did. I just pressed the button and this happened.
What button did you press?
Oh, no idea. I don't know. Just any button. I hated the game so much I threw the controller across the room and then something happened. I don't know.
Millions of people are throwing their controllers across the room.
Everybody starts trying that. I'll throw it.
Yeah.
I hope it is. I hope it's some kid that doesn't know what he did, like doesn't grasp the significance at all.
Just
be the best.
Pure dumb luck who's managed to get his name on the center of the bloody galaxy where the rest of us have been, you know.
It'd be hilarious.
Oh my god. Running around with hands on our what-sits. not knowing what the hell we're doing. Trying to figure out stuff. And this kid just gets to the center, chucks his controller at the wall, and bang, he's discovered it.
Just like that.
Just like that, yeah. So.
Oh, man.
I've got the day off today. Normally I don't work Saturdays, but it's my other half's hen do today. So I have to stay home. She's going in the afternoon, starting in the afternoon, so I'm staying home looking after Charlie today.
Right.
Any excuse for a day off work.
Yeah. So you'll be streaming through that throughout the day at some point, I'm sure.
At some point, yeah. So, yeah.
Nice. Well, good morning to Britain and, you know, all the people in those time zones.
Oh, they're probably smart and still in bed.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What is it, 6 a.m. there? 6:30 a.m. almost?
7:22. So
oh, 7, that's seven. Right.
Normally I'd be leaving for work in about 8 minutes. I'd be up getting dressed, doing my hair and all that crap at the moment.
Wow.
I'd be leaving for work normally.
Rob, we even leave for work at the same time in the morning, Rob.
Do we? There you go.
I'm out the door at 7:20 every day. I try to be. 7:30 is my like absolute cutoff.
Right, yeah.
That's hilarious.
How long does it take you to get to work?
20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Well, about 22.
About 10.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm at work for an hour. I get to work, you know, so I'm starting at 8 o'clock and then I finish at 6 o'clock. And
yeah.
Come on.
That's the life, eh?
That's the life I'm trying to get rid of.
Exactly.
But at the moment, YouTube. I'm only making about $15 a month off YouTube, so not including tips. So I've still got a way to go yet before I can give up on the work. So
yeah, one day at a time, man. One day at a time.
Yeah. One day at a time.
That's how we do.
I've got a feeling we could be, I don't know, we might be jumping through today, Mike.
Yeah, where's Peter? How close is he?
I don't tell Tony this, she's not up yet. But I introduced Peter to a method to guarantee he will win his race. It's called remote play.
Oh, nice.
Because he has to give up the TV, so he can't play. And then he's talking to me on the laptop, and I said, "Hey, man, have you ever tried remote play?" And he's like, "Remote play? What's that?" And I said, "Hey, let me send you the link."
Wow. So wait, you can do that from a laptop?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
So, you didn't know?
No.
Well, let me introduce you to remote play.
Yeah.
So if you've got a laptop, all you need is your PlayStation 4 controller, you download the software and you plug it in by USB cable to your laptop or desktop computer.
Oh,
and then
God.
If the main TV is being used and you can't get on your PS4, then you can remote play to your laptop or computer. And
wow.
So Pete had started doing that. So he was on yesterday chatting to me and I said, "How are you doing?" And oh, so what are you doing? He said, "Remote playing." so he must be close.
Huh.
So no, don't tell Tony.
Oh man.
So yeah. So so here's the deal. If we do jump through, I've made the commitment that will be the jump through and the consequences after that will be my final stream as
really?
Exploring No Man's Sky. Yeah.
Okay, and then you're going to switch the name?
And then I'll be rebranding. So
nice.
it's a bit of a big event for me personally. So
yeah, you've been building this channel up for a while.
Yeah. Then I'm going to switch, and I'll still play No Man's Sky to begin with, because I've decided that my launch title, my first non-No Man's Sky game, is going to be Evlyaquel.
Oh, nice.
On PlayStation VR.
Oh.
So that's going to be my first... Well, it's called Exploring the Virtual, and part of that was virtual reality, not just virtual, though. It was a double meaning. So I'm going to, the first thing I'm going to do, which is non-No Man's Sky related, will be Evlyaquel on PlayStation VR. And hopefully that'll be on Thursday, because that's when it all gets released.
Nice.
So I'm hoping to get delivery on Thursday next week. So that'll be it. Evlyaquel is a game I've been waiting for many times. Because like Jenny P, I used to be a big Eve player.
Yeah, so you guys have talked about that. Interesting.
Yeah.
I've never really seen much of that game at all, so that'll be good. I'll watch that for sure.
A complex game. It's a complex game. It's got a steep learning curve. Really has,
really?
And that's why a lot of people give up on it really early. But once you've got past that learning curve, it can drag you in. It can pull you in, really.
Yeah, it sounds
really
like
can.
It.
So, yeah. It was Elite Dangerous before Elite Dangerous, but without the landing on planets. You couldn't land on planets. But it's got better, you know, trading and all that. It's got all of that in. You can be a miner. You can be a trader. You can, you know, move goods from one planet to another. But it's big money, though. It's not, like, little money. And people have actually lost within the game. People have been pirated and literally have lost thousands of dollars worth of stuff. Like,
wow.
Literally. Like, because you can buy game cards, you know. It's like a subscription service. You can actually buy game cards, game time cards, like, for a month at a time. And a lot of people buy those in game and then sell them to other players in the game, because you can actually sell them in the game.
Huh.
So it's a commodity of the game that you can actually sell. So people, good morning, Charlie. So people, guess who's awake?
Good morning, Charlie.
Like, so some people stupidly decide that they're going to take all these game cards that they've purchased, and it could be literally thousands of dollars worth that they've purchased, and then move them from one station to another system. And the problem is, if you're in space where you can be pirated, you can be pirated. And if you've got them on you and your ship blows up,
that's
you lose
awful.
Them. And so there are people who have actually lost thousands of dollars playing that game.
To pirates.
You know, so because of pirates, real. They said this, you do it, it's at your own risk. You know, there's absolutely zero reason to move them. You don't have to move them. They sit in a station. You don't have to move them. You can sell them from that station. There's no need to move them. But people have moved them and lost them.
Yikes.
So there you go. So it's an intense game.
Yeah.
Let me just say hello to Charlie.
Okay.
Good morning, Charlie. What were you saying?
And to those of you listening to Gaming Mike's stream right now and watching, thank you for joining. Be sure to hit that like button if you're enjoying it. I'm in voice chat with Rob of Exploring No Man's Sky. I'll have Nightbot put a link to his channel in the chat right now. And be sure to check him out. He was just talking a little bit about what he's going to be doing with his channel in the coming weeks. Should be good.
No, I'm like...
And thanks for tuning in. That's Charlie in the background, too.
He's just woken up. Why don't you go lie with Mummy? She's still in bed.
I just woke up.
I know you've just woken up. He's not going.
How long have you been streaming?
I'm not streaming. I'm just talking to Mike. Because I've just woken up, so I'm not streaming. Okay? Love your pajamas, by the way. Darth Vader. I might have to get a pair of fart beater pajamas. No, fart maker. That was what it was called, not fart, but oh, boy.
You're, when you were stepped away from your stream the other day, you had it play in your old videos. I saw for the first time your Darth Vader in the tub.
Yeah.
I hadn't seen that one before. Oh, man. Some of those old videos are pretty great.
I know. I've got so hooked up in the streaming of things. I mean, the new channel is going to start doing things like that as well. And I'm going to get back into actually the video making side of things. But I had to do something to fill the void before No Man's Sky was released. So I used to make those little videos.
Yeah.
Bit of fun.
I like the outtake of you climbing into the tub after the video.
Yeah.
Very, very yes. gently climbing into the tub.
Oh, it was bloody freezing.
It looked like it. Oh,
it was
man.
So cold. It was so cold. And then Marley pissing on the side of it. That was just classic.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
so you never went back and watched my original video.
I went back. I scrolled back a little ways in your channel and saw some of the older ones, but I didn't go all the way back.
Oh man, you should see the introduction video, the first video I did where I introduced the channel and who I was, and I did a full bit on. There was a full disclaimer at the start saying that this video will contain full frontal nudity and all that, and it did contain full frontal nudity, but yeah, you'll have to
held up. Yeah, I saw that one. I did see that one.
You held up, Mark. Yeah.
I was gonna say it, but then I didn't want to spoil it for anybody else.
Yeah.
I cut myself off.
A bit of laugh, a bit of fun.
Yeah, I still need to make an introduction video for my channel. I keep thinking about it, but I've certainly not done that.
I've got to make a new one. I might be on my to-do list today, actually, make a new one, because if I'm going to change the channel, you know, it could be in the next 24 hours. Oh. I'm going to need one.
Holy cow, I just found the view. Wow. From yellow to red. Very stark. Oh, get
which
the ships.
System are you
the
in?
Ships. Somewhere on the way back to Meeting Place. I forget what it's called, but I just stopped to poke around, find some animals, get some time-lapse videos. Holy cow.
Poke around as you do on a Friday night.
Yeah, well. You know.
Sorry, I did ask you the other day, but then I didn't really see if you answered me because I got caught up in whatever I was doing, which is what I always do. Rob needs a channel where he just laughs at anything remotely phallic.
He has it. It's Exploring No Man's Sky on YouTube. Oh,
God. Yeah. Got that already. But how did your lunch date go?
Oh, it was quite nice, actually. Yeah.
Quite nice.
Interesting. Interesting time.
Interesting. Really?
Well, she's 10 years older than me.
I thought you were going to say she's 10 years old.
Right. Nope.
I know you're in Utah and all that, but...
Nope, that's not what I was saying at all. Nope.
So, how old does that make her then? She's 10 years
old.
43. She's the same age as Sue then.
Oh, okay. Right on.
Where was Sue yesterday at your lunchtime?
Shit.
Right. I thought you were older than that. I thought you were closer to 39 than...
No, sir. Then 33 this year.
No. God, no, I really am the old man of the group, aren't I?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Luckily, you can be as immature as you want to. Doesn't matter.
Exactly.
So... God, I'm getting old. There used to be a stage where I always used to be the youngest in a group, and now I seem to like always be the oldest. It's a bit weird.
Did all of those other people from your other groups stop playing video games?
Yeah, maybe.
I think I solved it.
I'll never stop. Mastiero 666 was timed out by Nightbot for 5 seconds. Damn you, Nightbot.
Oops. First warning.
Oh, is Mastiero older? Oh, he's 37 in 12 days.
Yep.
So he's not older than me. Is there anybody... Well, I know there are a couple of people who are older than 46 in chat groups and everything, but
yeah,
anyone who streams older than 46 that I'm aware of.
Oh,
I've been told I don't look 46, though, so that's good.
Oh, I found some teeny little moth... Oh, dragonfly-looking things. What are they? Or are they big and far away? I can't tell. Scan it. No! They're getting away.
Stevie B41 is 48.
Oh, there you go.
But do you stream? That's just it. Do you stream YouTube?
Why won't it scan? There. Got it.
I have zero friends who... Yeah, you should have just stopped at I have zero friends. Sorry. Who play video games. My friends are all marathon runners, models, artists.
Oh, it's a little birdie with freaky moth wings. A birdie. Say that again. That sounded hilarious birdie. When you said it.
It's a little birdie.
Oh, that was the last animal on the list. I did it. 100% complete. Boom, I'm done. I win. I win this planet. Oh, Nebular Nusquam, welcome. Just in time to get a waypoint named after you. Who else is in the chat that I haven't named something after tonight? You better say something. I'm going to leave this planet soon.
Me.
Yeah, I'll name one after you. I've got two more to do. If I don't get two more out of chat. If I don't get two more out of chat, I will. I don't think I named one after Steve. Animal?
You found a big fat animal to revenge yourself for yet?
I found lots of... I just found all the animals on this planet, but you know what? I haven't been changing their names, Rob. I just haven't been doing it.
God, what's wrong with you? I
was going to tell you why.
We can have an influence on this game. No, I'm not interested in why. Just fucking do it. It's like, it leaves your mark. It tells people who you are, what your sense of humor, your sense of being. I'm just boring gaming Mike who doesn't like to change the name of things, except waypoints, which nobody is going to find anyway. But people have a better chance of finding animals. But, oh, I'm just going to leave them with their stupid Latin names.
Do it in your American accent, though. You got to do that in your American accent.
I don't have an American accent. I don't know what you're talking about, because I don't have an American accent. My name's Gaming Mike. And I'm really boring. Because I like to name waypoints that nobody's ever going to find, but animals which will be discovered by the likes of me and you and everybody else. I just want to leave them as they are and not change their name at all, because I'm boring gaming Mike. Yeehaw!
Wait, throw birdie in there. Throw birdie in.
Now I'm going to go play me some golf and hope I get a birdie.
There it is. That's perfect. Oh, man. Oh, that's Exploring No Man's Sky, everybody. Exploring No Man's Sky on YouTube.
That is.
That's his American accent impression.
Yes, that's the best I can do, because I don't do accents very well.
I'm going to have to start getting used to calling you Exploring the Virtual, I guess.
Exploring the virtual.
Yeah.
Oh, God. ETV.
ETV.
ETV. ETV.
That's right.
Be good.
Why am I 7 minutes away from my ship? Oh, that's not good. I need a recall point. What's over there?
Or you could just run. 7 minutes. If you fly, it's only 3 minutes.
That's true. I've stood longer in one place just watching the sunset in this game. It would help if I had some jetpack right now, though. Oh, what are you? Get out of here.
What am I? Human being?
No, I ran afoul of a strange beast. But it's okay. It wasn't a predator. Oh, I have to climb this entire mountain.
Climb every mountain!
That's beautiful. Just warming up your voice for the day.
Yeah. Probably lose it. Wait. Stop. Don't move. Don't move. Right.
Fabian, welcome to the chat.
Right, now turn right.
Okay.
Turn.
There's a pineapple on the horizon. Further? What am I doing?
Well, time delay, mate.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God, Rob, I know what you're doing. I turned right far enough. I saw it, Rob. I know what you're up to.
What, you don't want... Oh, you kept going.
Oh, look at this Dr. Seuss tree.
Oh, yeah, you'll stop and look at the Dr. Seuss tree, but the giant phallic rock, no. That looks like a toilet brush. Call it toilet brush. Toilet brush. Call it toilet brush. It's a toilet brush.
I will name it toilet brush.
Name it toilet. Call it Rob's toilet. I'm going to name this Rob's toilet brush. And then I'm going to go play me some golf and get a birdie. Oh, it doesn't look like a toilet brush in there. But it looked like a toilet brush on the game.
Yeah. Oh, well. It's different. There you go. Rob's toilet brush. Rob. That's how you spell that.
Rob's. Rob. Now you made me look like I'm a Muslim. Rob.
No, it had three H's.
Three H's. Oh, sorry. My mistake.
Yeah.
Well,
let's see.
How far are you away from Fabian? Your ship now?
Oh, still a couple minutes.
Fabian.
Sounds
so exotic, doesn't it? My name is Fabian. I have hair that you would love to put your hands through.
Oh, you're thinking of Fabio.
Yeah, I know. Fabian. My chest is so greasy and oiled, the light, it shimmers off her, it's... the women, they just fall at my feet. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Fabian. Sorry. He's probably bald. Probably just really insulted.
probably bald.
Got no hair.
Well, you can't see the top of his head in his profile picture, so.
No, exactly. I can't.
For all we know.
I can't.
I'm not gonna make it. Oh, shit.
Is that because you went too early? You went to a premature
jet-paculation.
Jetpaculation. Premature jetpaculation. That was it. I was trying to. Yeah. Premature.
I got you.
Yeah,
you got did. You.
Yeah, you got. You didn't. You didn't wait for it to fill up before you decided to release. Yeah. So
it actually happens to me a lot in this game, and I'm not afraid to admit that.
Yeah, you suffer a lot of premature jetpaculation.
That's right. I'm always running out. I'm always leaping too soon.
Yeah, yes. Saf Jazz just said we can't see Mike's hair either.
You can see some of my hair in my profile picture. It's hanging about my shoulders luxuriously. Thank you very much.
Whoa. I am not offending anybody.
Did you offend somebody?
No, Masked Hero is claiming I'm offending everyone. How am I offending it? It would... here's something.
I think he just wanted this reaction that you're giving him right now.
Yeah, I know. I am like... I am so baitable. It is unbelievable. You may have noticed if you follow my streams on a regular basis.
Yeah. Well, anyway, when it comes to baiting you, I think Masked Hero is the master.
Yes, but he thinks he's funnier than me. I'm not going to bait. I'm not going to rise. I'm not going to. I'm not answering that. Put your money where your mouth is. Then Mike has nothing wrong with a mullet. I had a mullet a couple of years back until I decided it didn't really suit me. I grew my hair long because Sue has a thing for Steven Seagal. So I thought, I'll grow my hair long because, you know, she likes long hair on men. But it didn't quite work out as well as she hoped, I don't think.
Yeah. It's a tough look to pull off. You got to be dedicated. And you can't shave the top of it off and leave the back of it long. You just can't do that. That's not part of it.
No, I did the full-on, like, just swept back ponytail, whatnot, but it just didn't look right. I think you need to have jet black hair to pull that off, and I don't have jet black hair, you know, so...
Yeah.
It just... And plus, it was just all wavy, and I've got quite a high forehead, and it was like, ugh, God. So yeah. It just didn't look right. And that was back when I was wearing glasses as well, so it just looked really bad. Maybe I could pull it off now with a... It looked better when I didn't have my glasses on, I must admit. But there you go.
Yep. All right, well, you know what? I'm going to wrap it up for the evening. I'm getting pretty tired. So I would like to thank everybody who joined me in chat tonight. Sure appreciate you guys being along for the journey. Be sure to hit that like button on your way out if you had a good time. Subscribe if you want to see more in the future. Thanks especially to the new people who filtered through tonight. Good to see some new faces in the chat. Thanks to Rob from Exploring No Man's Sky for dropping by in the voice chat, and good morning to you over in Britain. Watch his channel later. He'll be streaming. I just had Nightbot put a link to him in my chat. And I will catch you next time for some more No Man's Sky. That does it for me. I'm Gaming Mike. Thank you. Have a wonderful evening.
And goodbye, everyone. I do get you, Mars Hero. I completely do get you. But you clearly don't get me. I do get you. I get you. We're both Australian in our own special ways. So I think we have the same sense of humour. But yeah, there we go. But yeah, I'll be streaming a little bit later on, guys. Not now. I'm going to go upstairs and see if I can enjoy my other half.
Excellent phrasing. All right. Good night, everybody.